In part 3 of The Rime of the Ancient Mariner, the mariner spies something approaching from the west. It's a ship that seems to move without wind or current, and it comes toward them. He bites his own arm and sucks the blood to relieve his thirst so he can speak, crying out, "A sail!" It is a ghost ship with tattered sails and a cracked hull. The ship is sailed by death and life in death. The two are playing a game of dice for the mariner's soul. Life in death wins the game. The entire crew, save for the mariner, drop dead. Their souls zip past him, leaving him alone on the ship with their bodies. The thirst continues, robbing the mariner and crew of their voices. This is another form of punishment, a contrast to the penance the mariner must perform later in the poem with his act of confession in this tale of woe to the wedding guest. The mariner cannot even attempt absolution because he cannot even pray for forgiveness. In fact, the mariner must bite his arm and drink his own blood in order to counter the thirst that has made him unable to speak. He pays a price in blood to regain his voice, which reinforces the Christian references all through the poem. Christ's blood turns into wine during the sacrament of the Eucharist via transubstantiation. The drinking of it is to imbibe in Christ's blood shed for salvation. The mariner drinks his own blood to be able to hail the strange ship, thinking it will offer salvation to him and the crew. But hope for salvation is dashed when the mariner perceives the ship's appearance as it approaches. He can make out the tattered, ghostly sails, and the ship's ribs show through its damaged hull. It's a horror, not a savior, made only worse when he sees death and the woman beside him. Coleridge introduces the supernatural into his natural world, turning the whole scene otherworldly. The natural order is overturned as life in death wins the dice game and the sun disappears, night falls, and the moon rises. It's like the mariner and his ship have crossed over into some strange world where nature no longer makes sense, where the rules have been reordered.